नमस्कार, आई एम दहन गावड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मैथमेटिक्स, सेंटर फॉर डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन, शिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी कोल्हापुर। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस विद यू इनर प्रोडक्ट स्पेस। इनर प्रोडक्ट स्पेस फ्रॉम द लीनियर अलजेब्रा, एमसी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर सेकंड। एंड इन इनर प्रोडक्ट स्पेस पॉइंट इज अ रेंज ऑफ लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस। डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेंज ऑफ लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस: If T belongs to A of V, then the range of T of V is defined by T of V is equal to V such that V belongs to V. V belongs to V. Theorem, one more theorem. If V is a finite dimensional vector space over F, then T belongs to A of V is regular if and only if T maps V on to V. That is, V is finite dimensional vector space over F. For suppose that, for proof, we have to suppose that T belongs to A of V is regular. For V belongs to V, we have T into T inverse of V is equal to V. Therefore, T of V is equal to V, and hence T is onto. Conversely, suppose that T is onto, suppose that T is not regular, which is contradiction. T is not regular, therefore T is a singular, then there exists a scalar vector V is not equal to 0 in V such that T of Vn is equal to 0. V1 is not equal to 0, we can extend to form a basis for V as V1, V2, dot, 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 Vn. Then every element in T of V is a linear combination of the element W1 is equal to T of V2, W1 is equal to T of V2 dash the Wn is equal to T of Vn. Therefore, dimension of V less equal n minus 1, dimension of V less equal n minus 1 less than n is equal to dimension of V. But then T of V must be different from V, that is, T is not onto, and which is contradiction. Therefore, T is a singular or regular. T is a singular. Next one definition: rank of T, rank of linear transformation. If V is a finite dimensional vector space over here, then the rank of T is the dimension of T of V, the range of T over F. The range of T over F, we denoted by rank of T is R of T. We denoted by rank of T is R of T. Remark that if R of T is equal to dimension of T, rank of T is equal to dimension of T, then T is a regular. T is a regular. Second one, if gamma of T, R of T is equal to 0, that is, rank of T is equal to 0, then T is equal to 0. And so is T is singular, not regular. One more theorem or lemma. If V is finite dimensional vector space over F, then for ST belongs to A of V, prove that R of ST is less equal R of T, R of TS is less equal R of T, R of ST is equal to R of TS is equal to R of T, or S is regular in A of V. Now we have to prove that first R of ST is less equal R of T. Since S of V is less than V, therefore dimension of T S of V is equal to is less equal dimension of T of V. Therefore, R of T is less than R of T. Suppose that R of T, second one, prove R of T is equal to M. T of V has a basis of M elements, M W1, W2, dot, 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 W M. But then S of T of V is spanned by S of W1, S of W2, dot dot S of WN. Hence, has dimension at most m. Since R of ST is equal to dimension of S of T, S T of V is equal to dimension of S of T of V is less equal m is equal to dimension of R of T of V is equal to dimension of rank of T. For third one proof, if S is invertible, then S of V is equal to V. Then S of V is equal to V. And TS of V is equal to T of S of V is equal to T of V. And R of ST is equal to dimension of TS of V is equal to dimension of T of V is equal to R of T. On the other hand, if T of V has W1, W2, dot 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 WM as a basis of the regularity of S implies that S of W1, S of W2, dot dot S of WM are linearly independent. Therefore, for alpha 1, alpha 2, dot 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 alpha m belongs to F, alpha 1 S of W1 plus alpha 2 plus S of W2 dot 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 plus alpha m S of WM is equal to 0. S of alpha 1 W1 plus alpha 2 W2 S of alpha 2 plus W2 plus dot 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 plus S of alpha m WM is equal to 0. That is S of alpha 1 W1 plus alpha 2 W2 plus dot 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 plus alpha m WM is equal to 0. This implies that alpha 1 W1 plus alpha 2 W2 plus dot 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 plus alpha m WM is equal to 0. This implies that alpha 1, alpha 2, dot alpha m all are 0 and it spans S of T of V. They form a basis of S T of V. But then R of ST is equal to dimension of ST of V and dimension of T of V is equal to R of T. It is proof. One example for rank. Let V and W be the vector spaces over the field F and let T be a linear transformation from V on into W. If T is invertible, then prove that the inverse function T inverse is a linear transformation from W to V. When solution for this example, when T is 1 1 and on 2, then there is uniquely determined inverse function T inverse which is maps W and V so that T inverse T identity on V and T into T inverse and identity on W. We claim that T inverse is linear. We have to prove that T inverse is linear. We have to show that for alpha beta belongs to W or belongs to F and W1 W2 belongs to W, T inverse of alpha 1 alpha W1 plus beta W2 is equal to alpha T inverse of W1 plus beta T inverse of W2. For that, suppose that W1 W2 belongs to V W and there exists V1 V2 belongs to V so that T of V1 is equal to W1 and T of V2 is equal to W2. Now that is V1 is equal to T inverse of W1 and V2 is equal to T inverse of W2. Therefore T of alpha V1 plus beta V2 is equal to alpha T of V1 plus beta T of V2 is equal to alpha W1 plus beta W2. Therefore T inverse of alpha W1 plus beta W2 is equal to T inverse of T of alpha V1 plus beta V2 is equal to alpha V1 plus beta V2 is equal to alpha T inverse of W1 plus beta T inverse of W2 and hence T inverse is linear and therefore टी इनवर्स मैप्स फ्रॉम डब्लू टू ऑन टू वी, देयरफॉर